the desperate last dash to sanctuary. Entire families leaving torched homes and death behind. The Rohingya Muslims from Myanmar, a stateless ethnic minority, often called the most persecuted people on earth.
They are beating us, shooting at us, and hacking our people to death. Many women were raped and killed.
400 people have been killed, says state media, and the UN has declared nearly 125,000 Rohingya have fled across this border into neighbouring Bangladesh in just 10 days, after Myanmar soldiers and Rohingya militants escalated what's fast becoming war.
We were tortured by the military and their accomplices. We had to flee to save our lives.
Last Friday, the military killed 5 people in our area. One of them was my son. They were tortured to death. Our houses were set on fire. We lost everything there.
We can't verify their stories ourselves, and the office of Myanmar's de facto leader, Aung San Suu Kyi, didn't reply to request for comment. It's a journey only slightly less perilous than the hell they leave behind. Many in Myanmar simply don't want them there, so their homes are burned, fleeing gunfire with their lives and families on their backs.
We had to walk a long way. We had to cross hills, marshes and paddy fields to make the journey to the Bangladesh border.
But sometimes it's the crossing that kills them. 12 children and 8 women drowning when their boat was capsized. But even then, they don't find solace. Bangladesh has forced 1,000 to go back to Myanmar in just the last week. And a staggering 20,000 are caught in limbo, in a no-man's land on the border, without food or water. Myanmar has for years been unfriendly to the Rohingya, but the explosion of violence comes from Myanmar soldiers doing what they say are clearance operations against, quote, extremist terrorists, who they blame for attacking other ethnicities. In turn, the Rohingya have admitted using their militants to attack police, killing 12 a week ago, but in the defence of Rohingya rights. Mothers forced to flee, but also to leave their sons behind to fight.
I've sent my son to fight. I'm leaving him at the hand of the Almighty Allah. We are ready to face any situation.
An unwelcoming void ahead of them, ashes and agony behind. Nick Patton Walsh, CNN.